Dee Dee, and welcome to Dee Dee's Expressions. For this week's video, I decided to bake. So I made an apple butter pound cake. If you're interested in seeing how I did that, please stick around for this video. If you like the video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you'll know when I upload new videos. Okay, let's get into baking. Whenever I'm baking, I like to gather my ingredients first and have them sitting out on the counter so I don't forget. And this way, I'll know if I've used everything. I'll list the ingredients below in the description box, but I use 3 cups of flour, 3 cups of sugar, 6 eggs, 1.5 cups of butter, 1 package of cream cheese, 1 cup of apple butter, 1/4 cup of toasted nuts, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. I start by whipping together the butter and the cream cheese. I do this for approximately 2 minutes or until it's creamed really well together. Scrape down the sides of your bowl and scrape down the sides of your paddle attachment, and then go ahead and slowly add in your sugar. I've sped up this process, but I did slowly add in the sugar. It just looks a little faster, again, because it's sped up. Once you have the sugar all incorporated, you're going to let that mix for a little, scrape it down, and then you'll want to add in your eggs, one at a time. Add your salt to your flour and then mix with your fork to ensure that when you add it to the sugar mixture, that it will be evenly distributed. Once you have all your eggs added, go ahead and add your vanilla. Then you're going to scrape down your bowl just a little again to make sure that it's all incorporated, and then you're going to slowly add in your flour. Once I add in all the flour, I allow the mixer to run for maybe 10 to 15 more seconds and then I turn the mixer off. I continue to fold in anything else that's left on the side by hand, and I do this to make sure that I don't overmix my batter. It's important that you don't overmix your batter. With clean hands, you can go ahead and scrape down the batter off of your paddle attachment. Make sure that you clean your hands afterwards so that way you're not getting the stickiness on the side of your bowl. I know a lot of people are weird about touching batter, but truthfully, when you're cooking or baking, you're always touching things. And as long as your hands are clean, it's perfectly fine. One last mix and scrape down of my bowl before we move into adding the apple butter. So I have some pecans that are toasted and I chop those up in my food processor. So I'm going to add that to my apple butter and then I'm going to gently fold that into my pound cake batter. I'm going to do this in 2 stages so that way I can make sure it's evenly distributed throughout the entire batter. And you pour your batter into your prepared pans. I like using loaf pans for pound cake. I'm not really a fan of the bundt pans, but you can use whatever pans you prefer. Just make sure that your pans are properly greased and floured before you bake them, which is why I like to have my stuff already prepared before I even begin the process of starting my batter. Make sure you scrape down, get all the last of it, don't leave any in that bowl. And then once you're done, you're going to bake this in your preheated oven. Your oven should be preheated to 325. The baking is about an hour and a half or until a toothpick comes out clean. You're gonna let it cool on a wire rack in the pan for 10 minutes. And then after 10 minutes, you're gonna remove it from the pan and allow it to cool for another hour and a half on the wire rack, but outside of the pan. Once that's done, you can go ahead and slice it and enjoy it with more apple butter. My apple butter is homemade, or you can have it with ice cream, because that's how I like to enjoy it, with ice cream, because I'm greedy. So thank you for hanging out with me this week. If you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Follow me on social media at DD's Expressions. You can find me on Facebook and Instagram, and I will see you in my next week's video. Till then, bye.